Good morning, and a very warm welcome to you on this first Sunday in July. Well, we have first of all to say thank you to everyone who came to yesterday's maintenance morning. Thank you for all the work that you all did. That was wonderful. Thank you to all those of you who supported also the asylum seekers yesterday. We know that there were demonstrations, and certainly thank you to those who've been supporting them for a number of weeks and months now. Just to let you know that later today is our first ever Wild Church at 3 o'clock. We're meeting in the Garden of Remembrance, so if you can join us for that service, that will be great. Also, to let you know, on Tuesday at Twin Oaks Nursing Home is our Summer Songs of Praise at 2:30. And if you like singing and wish to come and join us, please get there a little bit before 2:30. Also, to let you know that the Alpha Course continues on Wednesdays, as does Hope Cafe on Tuesdays, and Tots on Thursdays, and Food Bank on Fridays. Also, this coming week is a premises meeting at Wednesday at 11:15. Next Sunday, we will be joining in the afternoon at 1 o'clock with Holy Trinity Church for a picnic at Eaton Park near the bandstand. We are combining our two lots of asylum seekers from that church and from our church, and they're getting together for a picnic lunch. So if you'd like to join us, please do so at Eaton Park, just by the bandstand. Also, if you are coming and would like to make a packed lunch for any of the asylum seekers, please let me know. Well, on to today's service, and we begin with these words from John's Gospel. Jesus said, "I am the bread of life. Whoever believes in me will never go hungry." Let's pray. God of all goodness and love, we gather in the name of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, the bread of life. Accept our praises and our love, and forgive us our sins. For your kingdom's sake. Amen. Well, we begin a new series for the first Sunday in the month, and the theme is Kingdom Parables. And each month we'll be taking a different parable about the kingdom of God and seeing what Jesus was saying to those listening to him, looking at what it now says to us. Today's parable is taken from Matthew chapter 13, a chapter full of parables. We're looking at just one verse, verse 33. He told them still another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed into about 60 pounds of flour until it worked all through the dough. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Well, just before that parable, the parable of the yeast, or if you know it in the old word, the parable of the leaven, just before that is another short parable that comes before it. The parable of the mustard seed, which I'm sure you know. Together with the parable of the yeast, these two parables balance the picture of the parable of the wheat and the weeds, which comes just before them. And these three parables together help us understand the parable of the sower, which is also in Matthew 13. So we've got these four parables. The sower speaks of various responses to the word of God's kingdom, but still looked forward to a time of abundant harvest. The parable of the wheat and the weeds showed that this harvest would grow up, but that good and evil must live side by side for the moment. And that also that there would be difficulties with weeds choking the wheat. But there would be a final triumph of God's kingdom when the harvest comes. Now, the two little parables of the mustard seed and the yeast speak after that of the promise and the power of God's kingdom. Their focus is on the certainty and the abundance of God's coming glory. You know, Jesus often used parables together, as he does here. But Jesus was rather unusual among the Jewish, the Jewish teachers of his day, and that he welcomed women among his followers. And here, in the parable of the yeast, his teaching reflects the work and world of women at the time. It was an everyday task to make bread in Jewish homes, as it is in many homes around the world still today. And it was usually the work of the women in the home to make that bread. Jesus used everyday things to teach about God's kingdom. And yeast was an everyday household item. I wonder, what would you choose to say something about God's kingdom? A teapot, perhaps? God's kingdom is like a woman who took a teapot and poured everyone a refreshing drink. Maybe you can come up with a better example. But as far as the parable of the yeast is concerned, Jesus doesn't say anything about the smallness of the yeast, like he mentions the size of the mustard seed. But he points to a hidden process, the rising of the dough because of the yeast within it. And although we cannot see the yeast working in the dough, we can see the effect that the yeast has. It increases the size of the dough. Of course, if you've ever made bread, you know that you need to prove the dough. That is, you let it rest, and while it's resting, it grows. Maybe there's something in that for us to take away today, while we are resting in God. We grow into the likeness of Christ. In this parable, Jesus also mentions a large amount of flour. The literal translation is 3 measures of flour. The modern translations often give it an amount, or just say a large amount of flour. But that 3 measures of flour amounts to more than 50 loaves of bread, enough to feed a whole crowd of hungry people. Now, maybe Matthew puts the parable where he does because of what comes in the next chapter. Or maybe Jesus was hinting at what was to come, because we read in Matthew 14 about the feeding of the 5,000. The hidden nature of the yeast in the dough speaks of the kingdom of God growing quietly in an unseen way, but certainly an effective way. You know, the parables Jesus told have the ability to reveal something of God's kingdom to us too, as well as those who first listened. Yet to a certain extent, they remain hidden. So Jesus' parable of the yeast, and his other parables to that matter, both reveal and conceal. They explain, but they also exclude. Those listening then, and we who listen now, we have work to do. We have to put our thinking caps on. We have to meditate upon Jesus' words to try and understand them. What was he saying then, and what is he saying now to you today about the parable of the yeast, God's kingdom at work in you? You know, Jesus' vision of God's kingdom is of a kingdom with inner power, a power to change from within, a power that reaches quietly, yet has great impact. So, how are you seeing God's kingdom growing in you? Maybe that's one to take away and think about. Let's pray. Loving God, when everything around us seems to cloud and obscure your love, give us a calm and confident faith to watch and wait for the coming growth of your kingdom work. We pray for those who need a sign of your kingdom power in their lives this week. And this we pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Thank you for joining me this week, and we close with a prayer. Let's pray. Gracious Lord, who increases your kingdom rule within us like yeast in dough, help us to walk in your ways and declare your kingdom for your glory's sake. Amen. And now may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and with everyone you love, now and forevermore. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve and share the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. I look forward to seeing you again next time. Bye for now.